Hello, church. We're so excited as a worship team to join with you to connect our living Father this morning. Come, let's worship the Lord and acknowledge all the goodness and the grateful works that He has done. Hallelujah. We're going to worship Him and exalt His name.
Hallelujah. I welcome you in this place, oh God, oh God, oh God. Welcome, Holy Spirit. We are in your presence. Fill us with your power. Live inside of me.
Come on, church, join with us and welcome this Holy Spirit.
Welcome, Holy Spirit. Welcome, God. We are in your presence. Oh, yes, we are. Won't you fill us with your power? Live inside of me.
Let's acknowledge Him
as the living water. You're the living water. Never trying water. Comforting counselor. Take complete control.
Of the Lord, the God of glory, the Lord of hosts is in our midst. So shall we all praise Him and give Him all glory? Amen. I give you praise till I owe.
God that we serve is a way maker. How many of you believe this? He is our light in the darkness. No matter what, He will never leave us nor forsake us, church. Let's acknowledge the great God this moment and worship Him. Hallelujah.
Time of worship we had. He is truly our way maker, our promise keeper. Greetings in the mighty and the matchless name of our Lord and Savior. Yes, He is our Savior. He is our Redeemer. He is our refuge. He is our strength. He is our Savior. He saved us from the muck and the mire of sin. He saved us from the world, flesh, and the devil. He saved us from all the strategies and the schemes and the plans of the enemy. And He has placed us now in a place of refuge, in a place of safety. The psalmist says in Psalm 91, He who dwells in the shelter of the Most High will abide in the shadow of the Almighty. I will say to the Lord, who is my refuge and my fortress, my God in whom I trust. For he will deliver you from the snare of the fowler. He will protect you from the deadly pestilence. He will cover you with his pinions, and under his wings you will find a refuge. His faithfulness is a shield and buckler. He says, you will not fear of the terror of the night, nor the arrow that flies by day, nor the pestilence that stalks in darkness, nor the destruction that wastes at noonday. 1,000 may fall at your side and 10,000 at your right hand, but it will not come near you. What assuring scriptures we have in this time of darkness, in this time of sickness and turmoil that we see around us. There's a lot of fear. There's a lot of pain. There's a lot of suffering around us at this in these couple weeks of lockdown that we have in our nation. But we do not have to fear, because the Bible keeps assuring us that we have a God who has not only saved us from the sins of the past, from the evils of the past, as Paul says to Timothy, he has saved us from the evils of the past, from the evils of the present, and will save us from the evils of the future. That is a blessed hope that we have in our God. I want to encourage you today, because of this hope that we have, let us continue to trust in God. Instead of fearing of what is happening around us, let us fill our hearts with faith in this God. In Psalm 46, we are encouraged, as the psalmist says, God is our refuge, God is our strength, a very present help in time of trouble. Truly, we live in time of trouble right now, but God is our strength and God is our help in time of trouble. He says, therefore, we will not fear, though the earth gives away, though the mountains be moved into the sea, though its waters roar and foam, though the mountains tremble at its swelling. We have a blessed hope in the Lord, because this world, there is going to be problems. In Isaiah chapter 24, verses 19 and 20, the earth is utterly broken. The earth is split apart. The earth is violently shaken. The earth staggers like a drunken man. It sways like a hut. Its transgressions lies heavy upon it, and it falls and it will not rise again. That's the world we live in. The world is broken. The world is split apart. The world is violently shaken. The nations are shaken. That is the true situation of our time right now. We are not promised a stability in this world. And that's why the psalmist says in Psalm 46, in the midst of instability, he brings us stable, a hope of stability. He says, though the earth gives away, though there is instability around us, though the mountains may be moved, though the waters roar and foam, though there are huge waves, tsunamis, all sorts of catastrophes that come against us, we will not fear. Why? Because God is with us. In verse 4, he beautifully says, there is a river whose streams make glad the city of God. I want you to see this contrast the psalmist is talking about. In the first three verses, he's talking about the ferocious instability of the world. And in verse 4, he says, but there is a river of God that makes glad the city of God. Can I draw your attention to this morning, in this evening, sorry, of what Jesus told us in John chapter 7, as Jesus is preaching his sermon in this great temple gathering. Jesus says, that day, there will come a day when the Spirit of God comes, where he will not just fill our hearts, but from within side, a river will flow. There is a river of God that brings refreshing. There is a river of God that brings hope. There is a river of God that satisfies. There is a river, he says here, of God, the streams that make glad the city of God, the holy habitation of the Most High. And the beautiful thing about it is, God is in the midst of her. Though there are storms raging around us, we need to understand there is a river, there is a refreshing that God brings into our life in the midst of the storm. It is a beautiful revelation when we are able to see that, just like the disciples when they were on the boat and the sea was raging, and these great expert fishermen look at that raging storm and say, we are all about to die. And Jesus was in the stern of the boat with a pillow under his head, sleeping in peace. He was trying to show them something. When they woke Jesus up, Jesus woke up and he commanded the storms, he commanded the rain and the seas to be calm. After he commanded the weather to be calm, Jesus looked at them and said, O ye of little faith. It was a time of revelation. Jesus was telling them something. What was he telling them? In the midst of all the storm and all the noise and all the chaos around you, I want you to know that God is in the midst of you. Emmanuel, what a promise. Emmanuel, God with us, just like he was in the beginning in the Garden of Eden with Adam and Eve in the Garden of Eden. God was with them after the fall in the kingdom of God as Jesus started to preach in Matthew. As soon as Jesus came, Jesus said, the kingdom of God is at hand. And that Jesus, Emmanuel, God with us, is with us in the storm. And he's telling his disciples that, I'm with you in the storm. The city of God, the river that flows from the city of God, God is in the midst of her, and therefore she shall not be moved. Why are we not moved? Why are we not afraid? Because God is with us. And he says in verse 5 in Psalm 46, God will help her when the morning dawns. God is our help. What a beautiful promise we received this year. Knowing not what 2020 had in store for us, God promised us in Isaiah chapter 41, verse 10, he said, fear not, I will be with you. I am your God. I will help you. That's what he's saying here. God will help us. Verse 6, he says, the nations rage, kingdoms totter, he utters his voice and the earth melts. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our fortress. I've said this many times in our church services. Think about it. The fortress, right? In those olden days, they built fortresses around a city. Why? To keep that city in protection, to keep it from the evil that is outside of those walls, outside of that fortress. Children of God, I want to encourage you today. Yes, COVID-19 is all around us. It's spreading. Coronavirus is spreading all around us. Every day, the numbers are going up. But fear not. Be wise. Do what is right. Be wise. Stay indoors. But also remember, we don't have to fear because God is our fortress. And he says, come behold the works of the Lord. He makes wars to cease. He breaks the bows. He burns the chariots with fire. But you, in verse 10, he says, be still. Be still and know that I am God. This is one of the hardest things for us as people who live in the 20th century, 21st century right now, is to be still. We are so cluttered with the busyness of this world, with all sorts of things around us, our gadgets, our friends, social media that keeps us so busy and so occupied. In this time, God wants, he's given us 21 days. He says, be still and know that I am God. Be still in that stillness. Let your heart come to know him in a personal way. Come to have a revelation of him. In the storm, can you find that calm? Can you find that stillness in him? Be still and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the nations. I will be exalted in the earth. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our fortress. Emmanuel, God with us, the Lord of hosts. In Psalm 24, he says, the Lord of hosts, the Lord mighty, that is who is with us. He is mightier than any pestilence, than any disease, than any problem that we have around us. The God that we serve is a mighty God, and that God is with you. So be encouraged today as you're watching this video. I want to encourage you, if you would close your eyes with me and pray. No matter what fear you're going through this week, we've been receiving many prayer requests, many calls from many houses, from our church, from many families, requesting prayers because of the fear that has surrounded them, because of the problems that they're going through, the uncertainty of the future, the instability of the situation that is surrounded us, what is going to be the nature of our jobs, what's the guarantee for our future. There's a lot of fear in this time. I would like to encourage you. Let us take our eyes away from all those things that are concerning us. Cast our burden on our Lord. Look to Jesus, who is the author and the finisher of our faith. And let us keep running this race with confidence, knowing that the Lord is with us. The God of Jacob is with us. That one thought should bring a lot of freedom in our mind and should empower us to keep running, because God, who created heaven and earth, who is the most absolute, ultimate authority of this world, of this universe, He is with us. Would you pray with me? Heavenly Father, we thank You for these assuring scriptures, for these encouraging scriptures that we were able to meditate and look into this evening time. You are our promise keeper. You are our healer. You are a God that we look to, and we shall not be put to shame. Father, in this time of fear and uncertainty, God, I pray, would You encourage Your people's hearts to know that You are with them? Would You cause us to be still in this time and to see Jesus in the midst of our storm? The God who calms the seas, the God who has absolute authority over every chaos, would You cause us to be still and know Him, to be still and understand His ways, to be still and have a revelation of You in this time of chaos? And may our hearts trust You. Though there is news of danger and problems and sickness and all sorts of warnings around us, may our eyes not look to those things and our hearts fear, but may our eyes look to You and our hearts be filled with faith this evening, O God. Touch Your people where they are. Let every fear cease. Let their hearts be filled with faith and trust in You. Continue to strengthen us in these 21 days that we can grow in You, that we can walk in faith. And in these 21 days, we can come out, Lord, victorious, sharpened in You, and full of the power of the Lord, full of the Spirit of God and anointing, Father. Cause us to rest well in this time. I pray that we will have a good time with our families and also the our loved ones that are around us, that we can share the love of Jesus and shine the light of the gospel for Your glory and the praise of Your name. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Stay tuned for the next 21 days. We are going to be putting these videos both morning and evening. Every day you're going to be hearing a encouragement, a teaching from God's Word that will encourage you. What a beautiful opportunity we have for the next 21 days where we can get sharpened in the Lord, we can grow in the Lord, and we can glow for God, right? So the next 21 days, morning and evening, you're going to get 10 to 15 minutes of devotion, a time of worship. Here's what we can also do. If you have never had family devotions or family prayer time, maybe you can use this as an opportunity where you can get your family together. You can worship together as our worship team is leading you in a time of praise and worship. You can hear the Word of God and you can spend some time in prayer together. So this is a beautiful opportunity for the next 21 days. Let's get sharp in the Lord. Let's fan the flame into all the gifts that God has placed into our lives, and let's make the best of what God has given us. God bless you.